Dear class 8, let's begin with the question answers. Oh, well for the sailor lad that he sings in his boat on the bay. First question, who is in the boat? A young sailor is in the boat. Second is, what does the fact that he is singing signify? The fact that the sailor is singing implies or signifies that he is joyful and happy. How does the poet feel when he realizes that he is singing? C part. Question number 1, C part is, the poet realizes that he cannot be as cheerful as him and his song reminds him of the voice of the dead friend whom he can't talk to anymore. Please note it down. The poet realizes that he cannot be as cheerful as him and his song reminds him of the voice of the dead friend whom he can't talk to anymore. Now let's come to question number 2. A part, but oh for the touch of a vanished hand and the sound of a voice that is still. What does the poet want to touch? The poet wants to touch his friend Arthur Hallam's hand. Next is, what does the poet want to hear? The poet wants to hear his friend's voice. Next question is, what is the mood of the poet when he writes these lines? What is the mood of the poet, children? The poet is nostalgic while writing these lines. The memories of his friend make him grim. Grim also means sad. Next we'll do question number B. First part, long answer questions. What is the poet thinking of as he watches the waves breaking on the shore? Please note it down. As the poet watches the waves breaking against the shore, he thinks about his inability to express his grief. Next is, what does the phrase "oh well" mean? The phrase "oh well" implies that it is good for or it works well for the fisherman's boy and the sailor to be merry. That means it's so good for both of these people, fisherman's boy and the sailor, to be merry. Merry over here means happy. Why does the poet envy the fisherman's boy? Envy means jealous. Why is he jealous of the fisherman's boy? The poet envies the fisherman's boy because he is cheerful and can express his joy. The poet envies the fisherman's boy because he is cheerful and can express his joy. Question number 4. What is the thing that will never return? His friend Arthur Hallam will never return. He will never be able to touch him or hear his voice anymore. The poet longs for the companionship which has been lost. Once again, children, go. This is the last. It's the question number 4. His friend Arthur Hallam will never return. He will never be able to touch him or hear his voice anymore. The poet longs for the companionship which has been lost. Next question is, whose voice is still? The poet's friend's voice is still because he has passed away. Next question is, what is the heaven? C part. What is the heaven under the hill? The heaven under the hill is the harbor that the ships sail into. In other words, it refers to the destinations where all journeys end. Why does the poet use the phrase "a day that is dead" to refer to the past? The poet's dear friend has passed away. For the poet, it is as if all the days that had been spent with his friend and all the happiness associated with those days have died too. Why is the sea a useful symbol? Does the sea comfort the speaker? The sea with its wave crashing on the shore becomes a symbol of the poet's grief breaking in upon his heart. It comforts the poet as the waves breaking in upon the shore can break away his inner pain and sorrow. Next, come to word study. Over here, a paradox has been explained. What is a paradox? It is a statement that has two opposite ideas that makes a statement seem untrue. But such statements are generally well founded. Right? Next is an elegy. Elegy is a poem or song that expresses sadness at the loss of a dear one. This poem was the poet's first published elegy for his friend Arthur Hallam. Okay, so that's what we discussed in the poem also. The poem has a paradox and an elegy. Okay, now first, now you can see the example of paradox shown over here. The silence is deafening. Silence is so quiet. How could it deaf, make you deaf? So, but the silence is deafening. This is an expression which is paradoxical. This is two opposite ideas expressed over here. Next is, quote two lines from the poem that are paradoxical. So, go through the poem and find out the lines which have opposite ideas. You can note down. And the sound of the voice that is still. Something that is still. Something that is still over here means dead. And having a sound. So, these are paradoxical. Please, you can just underline this and note it down. And the sound of the voice that is still. This is one paradoxical line. Next is, but oh for the touch of the vanished hands. Vanished hand is which is no more. Okay, disappeared. It's vanished means gone forever. So, and you are just wishing for the touch of that hand which is no more. Okay. Next is, write words and phrases from the poem which indicates sorrow and loss of a loved one. So that you have to go through the poem. You can note down. These are the lines which indicate sorrow. Oh, but oh for the touch of the vanished hand. This is one. Day that is dead. This is second. Cold grey stones. This is third. Just note it down. So with this we end the poem. Rest part is grammar study. This is not included in the syllabus. In the literature syllabus. What you have to do is go through the word meanings. Okay. Go through the word meanings. Read the poem properly. Okay. And note down that why does the poet say break over here. This shows that how emotionally he has grown, that he has been commanding the sea waves to hit the seashore. Just go through it properly. Read it thrice. Okay. And listen to the video and try to solve the, write the answers in your own words. Thank you.